Myself, Dr. Sanjeev Jain. I am representing Lakshmi Narain College of Technology at Bhopal. It is one of the premier institute at Bhopal in Madhya Pradesh. It is the first private engineering college in Madhya Pradesh. We are having the 8 UG branches and 9 PG branches. We are having an intake of 720 in the first semester. Basically, we are having the computer programming course, which is divided between the different branches. And we used to teach nearly 360 students in the first semester and 360 students in the second semester. This is the syllabus contents of the computer programming one, that is the CP1. It's starting with the what is something about the MS Office, MS Word, what is the difference between a procedure language and the object-oriented language, then moving towards the what is C, C++. Basically, I want to tell here, before this, we used to spend more time on the C language. Because what we are feeling, we are having the students mostly from the our board, MP board, and these students are not very much good in the programming concepts. So we like the students to be there with the C language. Then we used to move to this C++. As such, we are not having any theory class, or theory examination for this subject. So we only used to have the practical examination. And as this subject is common to all the branches, this course is conducted in both semesters. The plan is like this, the lecture is for 3 periods, no tutorials as such from the university, and P is for the practical exams, that is also for 3 classes. Basically, we are governed by the Rajiv Gandhi Technical University. As such, we are not having any freedom to change the things. But as it is a practical examination, so we are having some control to get the thing changed. Basically, this course consists of 100 marks. 50 marks is for the last end semester practical exams. And 50 marks is for the internal evaluation, I can say. That is 20 marks for the mid-sem test. This is also our college is conducting. As such, the university has specified the 50 marks for the internal assessment. It depends on the teachers. But we have made a mandatory test for the 20 marks and the 30 marks for the lab assignments they used to submit. Basically, we are having a separate lab for the computer programming in which we are having the 60 computers. We are having a LCD projector and we are having a whiteboard in that lab. The teacher used to teach the students in that class only, and it is well utilized. We are having, basically in department, we are having the 4 labs, a separate computer system, central computer center is also there. In each lab, we are having the 60 computers, with all machines are branded HCL or HP, with the P4 3.0 gigahertz, 1 GB RAM, 140 GB hard disk, and 15-inch monitors. The operating system generally in for this lab, for CP, we are having the Windows only. We are using the Turbo C, which is operated on these machines. But we are having some systems which are on the dual board. We are having booting of the Windows and Linux. Each lab is having a lab assistant. And to conduct this programming lab of a batch of 60, we require 2 teachers, which are also assisted by the sum of our TAs, from the M.Tech classes. Generally, for other classes, we use the chalk duster. For this, we are having the LCD projector and whiteboard facility, which is already fitted in the computer lab. It can be used there. I am having some of the assignments that I have recently. You can find these other assignments, which can be also done with the C, basically. Write a program to accept the 3 integers, write a program to 2 integers, swapping is there, odd and even numbers. And then some of the last 2 programs I can see for C++ we are making for this. Then we used to do at the last, a practical exam is there in which we used to give the students a particular test paper which consists of the question papers related to the programming. They are not theoretical, but they have to perform some of the programs and is to be evaluated by external and internal. That's all. Thanks.
An external examination.
Huh? It is a basically practical examination. External has to come and he has to evaluate the what the student is doing there.
This notion of external examiner is there in most places.
Yes.
This I call the British suspicion based system.
Basically, I was the TF when I was in the NAM Tech in IIT Delhi for CP1 only with Dr. B.N. Jain.
Couple of questions. You do not have a paper at all.
No, no.
So it's not a full subject. You still have lectures and lab.
Yes.
So you almost conduct it like any other subject.
Yes, yes.
Except the examination is practical examination.
Yes, yes.
And you do conduct a test there.
Yes.
So for all practical purposes, you are actually made it into a good subject kind of thing.
Yes.
With some lectures, lab and other thing. Except that you don't have a written test.
University is not given us, but we used to conduct one test, mid-sem test.
Can you go back to the syllabus there? I'm slightly worried about that syllabus, because that syllabus seems to be some kind of a museum of everything under the sun for computers.
Yes.
It is not just C++. How do you justify the use of MS Word, MS Office?
As we used to make a course completion plan, this unit is to be covered in only two lectures, not more than that. Basically, I am not able to.
I have two problems with this.
Yes.
Why do you specifically name product? Just like we have an objection to naming programming languages also, but you have to name it somewhere if you are using C or C++. The product has an implication. You said you have 60 computers per lab.
Yeah.
And how many labs do you have?
Four labs.
So you have 240 computers. Do you have
Central Computer Center is the
You have 240 licensed versions of MS Office?
Yes, yes. No, it is not like that. We are having the campus agreement with the Microsoft in which they supply 500 licenses with the campus agreement.
For the office?
Yes. For the
No. My dear friend, I spent my lifetime battling with Microsoft on the license issues. We have a license. But that campus-wide license permits you to load operating system basically. For every unit of office that you load, you have to pay them separately.
I will check it out because
Please go back and check because this is a major problem across the country. Secondly, your college, which was the first private college, and I know something about that institution by the way, where the management actually has been investing money in computing and other infrastructure. How many such colleges exist according to you in Madhya Pradesh?
That I cannot comment.
No, but the point is that if the university makes the syllabus, it becomes obligatory for every college in every lab to have these things.
Yes, sir.
That is the reason why we are saying that leave the choice of actual product to the organization. So, for example, in these 2 hours or something, what you want to tell them is that word processing, spreadsheet, these are basically office productivity tools.
Yes.
How does it matter if somebody uses OpenOffice, somebody else uses IBM Lotus Notes, somebody else uses this, how does it matter?
It depends on the choice of the student.
Will you please go back and tell our friends in Rajiv Gandhi University that they are doing a very sad thing by insisting on such products? Because I don't know, if I were to do a cyber crime cell and raid colleges, 90% colleges I will find are not complying with the license requirement, and that is not good, because you see, you and I are teachers, we think we are carrying out our job. Students are watching. They learn the first basics of doing chori from us. Should that happen? That's a serious question.
Yes.
The second question is, when you talk about token expressions, etc., are you basically talking about doing some sort of a parsing of expressions and so on, as we do in compilers? Because that is the only sense I can make out of the token. Where else could it be used? No. You are talking about token ring?
Token. No.
Token ring is not what is implied here.
Sir, the keywords identifiers in C++ are called as tokens in C++.
Oh, keywords identifiers are called as tokens in C++.
Basically, this is in the form of the units. But what the mail that I've got from a student, he has sent me like this, so I'm not able. It is managed in the
unifies, it may be dry, it may be somewhere it may be merged. So that's where the problem. Basically, due to the laboratory of not having the theory examination, we used to start with C. That is the main thing, because we want the students should learn first C, then go for the C++. This is one thing.
As a matter of fact, as you saw what Professor Ranade explained, so we might be, we say C and C++ is what we use, but essentially we delay the discussion of object-oriented concepts to a very last end, and we emphasize the routine elementary procedural concepts which everybody needs to know anyway. So you have that. What the problem I have is, you have your notions of function prototype, call by value, call by reference, etc., inline function, etc., even before discussion with arrays, even before discussion of classes and objects. So it looks like some sequencing problem I have, but that's my personal issue. People must have thought about defining this. But this is the syllabus which is now common for?
This is, we are having about 45 engineering colleges at Bhopal. And
in the colleges?
Bhopal.
Bhopal?
Yeah.
God bless you.
When you might be standing, there are only 8 colleges in Madhya Pradesh.
49 colleges in Bhopal alone?
Yeah, and total we are having about 120 colleges in Madhya Pradesh.
So 49 colleges, by going by your time, you have what, about 4 or 5 teachers teaching computer programming, right?
4 teachers.
4 teachers. So you take 49 colleges, even if they are smaller, because you are a larger institution.
Yes, we are the
at least biggest teachers in every college. So 100 teachers. Can you conduct a training orientation program for 100 teachers?
Sir, I will check it out and I will put it back. Okay.
So you run basically 3 courses.
But I don't think so it will be feasible for me, because I should have a good hands which can conduct the practical examinations. So I will check it out. That's why I am telling you. I will ask my some colleagues at the other college also so that I can do it.
This National Institute is also a remote center, isn't it?
Yeah, they are also a remote center.
Okay. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.